Well, ladies and gentlemen, that's it. It's over. I am trying to be as calm as I can. I'm not gonna lie. I'm more hurt than I am angry. 100%. I'm feeling more pain than I am anger. And if you guys are wondering why that is, it's because the inevitable happened. The inevitable happened. The day that I wish would never come has officially came and gone. Xander Bogaerts is no longer a Boston Red Sox. He is going to the San Diego Padres on a big payday. He deserves it 100%. I'm happy for him. No ifs, ands, or buts about that. In terms of where I stand with the Red Sox, I'm not angry that they didn't give him 11 years. What's making me angry with the Red Sox is that they never made legitimate competitive offers to him. That's what's frustrating. And the other thing that's frustrating is they waited till last second to actually be serious in this. And by the time they actually started to care, it was too late. They had spring training to get him for half the price. Bogaerts gave him the opportunity, I believe mid-season or whatever it was, to give him an extension. They came back with another stupid offer. Then Bogaerts was gonna let them have first dibs before he opted out. They didn't get to an agreement. He opts out. Then Bogaerts says to them, "I'll let you guys match the offer that I'm going to accept or make something close to it in order for me to stay, because I want to stay at the end of the day." And the Red Sox were just nowhere close whatsoever in terms of negotiations with Bogaerts. The best deal that they made to Xander was 6 years at $160 million. That is just absolutely unacceptable, disrespectful, and a slap across the face to Xander Bogaerts. He is the face of your franchise, well, was the face of your franchise, and you're only willing to give him 6 years when Turner just got 11. It's a slap across the face. He wanted to be here. He gave them every single chance possible to have him stick around. And at the end of the day, the Red Sox, once again, does not want to pay their homegrown talent. And with all that being said, I am going to stick by my claim that I made in a podcast. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm here to officially announce on YouTube also that I'm leaving Red Sox Nation. I can't get behind what this organization is doing. I can't get behind what they have done over and over and over again. John Lester, Mookie Betts, I would even go as far as saying Benny, because they got really nothing for him in return. And now Xander Bogaerts is on this list. I don't know what happened with this front office staff. I don't know what happened with this organization staff. Trust me, I feel fiery inside, but so right now it's currently 5:30 in the morning the next day. Now here we are. He's going to San Diego. And that's just that. To Red Sox Nation, I just want to say thank you for all the memories over the years. I will cherish every single moment that I've had cheering with you guys and all that, rooting for our team, rooting for championships day in and day out. And I just have the utmost love and respect for Red Sox Nation. I always will. They'll always have a special place in my heart. This decision has nothing to do with the fans. And honestly, it even has nothing to do with the current players on that team right now. It has nothing to do with them. It has nothing to do with the coaching staff either. This decision is genuinely made based off of the front office's actions and the fact that, excuse my language, that they do not give a fuck. They don't give a fuck. They don't care. All they care about is the dollar bill. And that's just what it is at the end of that. I was excited originally for Kenley Jansen and the Japanese guy that's coming over, because those were two solid pickups. I thought that all the Red Sox needed to do was re-sign Xander Bogaerts, get a couple more bats, get a few starters, and then we just run it back afterwards, and we'd be good to go. But now, I honestly don't see how they could recover from this, losing the leader of the clubhouse, losing a very talented player. You could argue he's one of the best shortstops in the league. Top five without a doubt. If they're not going to pay this guy, I'm telling you guys right now, they are not going to pay Devers. And it's not even the fact that Bogaerts is his buddy and all that. It's not even just because of that. It's just simply because of how Devers has seen this front office staff treat their players. That's first off. Second off, this team's not going to be good. They are not going to be good. Point blank, period. He's going to want to be on a winning culture. This organization right now has no idea what path they want to go on. They have no idea. So you think he's going to want to stick around for all this mess? Absolutely not. If I was Devers, I would request a trade out of Boston right now. I'd be calling my agent and simply telling him I do not want to be here. And that's just that at the end of the day. He will not be here past this year. So he's next. He's literally next to go. After he leaves, what do they have at the end of the day? They don't have anything. And honestly, if you are a Red Sox fan and you are debating whether or not you should stick by your team, I'm here to tell you that it is okay for you to hop off and not support what they are doing in their clubhouse. They're raising ticket prices. That is absolutely dead wrong. They're not even going to have a plausible team next year. You got Story. You got Devers. You got maybe Chris Sale if he ever comes back from an injury. They just got Jansen. They got the Japanese guy. Verdugo's all right, but he's nothing special. And what do they have really after that? They don't really have much after that. So, I just want to give a big FU to the Red Sox front office staff. I don't know when I could return as a Sox fan, honestly. It could honestly be after Bogaerts retires, Betts retires. I don't know. I don't know when I could gratefully say that I'm a Red Sox fan again. I don't know when I could do that. In terms of games like coming in the next years, they are on timeout. They're on timeout. The only time we are going to be going to games is when former beloved Red Sox players are returning to Fenway. For example, Mookie Betts returns to Fenway next season as a Dodger. He returns for the first time as a Dodger. We will be going to that. The Padres do not play the Red Sox here at Fenway next year. We're obviously not going to be seeing them. And that's about it. I'm not going to lie to you guys. That's about it. I might do like one or two extra ones just to meet up with my friends or whatever. But that is it. That's literally it. It's a low number. It is a low number next year. I would say at most 5 games. The last thing I will say to, this is going to Xander, this is going to his brother. Plain and simple, zoom in right now. Bogarts, I just want to say, this is my last time talking as a Red Sox fan, obviously. Bogarts, from the bottom of our hearts at Red Sox Nation, I just want to say thank you for all you've done here in Boston, for giving it your all every single night, for working your hardest to become the player who you've become, for developing this team to where it was, and bringing us 2 championships. For me personally, I just want to thank you for the countless amount of memories that I had with you. I've met you many times before, dating back to 2014. I used to go watch you a lot when you were in Pawtucket. And I'm not gonna lie, you are my favorite player of all time. You're my favorite player of all time. I met you first time in 2014, 2015. I had no idea, but this guy was trying to get me a baseball for the longest time. He kept underthrowing me, overthrowing me, so on and so forth. Then there was one game in September. He threw a ball to me. I had to make a lunging catch into the next row. Caught the ball. He's jumping up and down with joy and smiles and all that. Next day was on-field photo day. I show him the baseball saying, thank you for tossing this to me yesterday. He was pumped to actually meet me again. And he said to me, I've been trying to get you a ball. I've been trying to throw you this ball for a long time. I've noticed that you've followed my career from Pawtucket, and I appreciate the support. That's exactly what he said. Then after that, he first made an Instagram. He used to read all my messages that I sent to him. He liked a lot of them. He actually responded a couple times to me. Face to face, he recognized me. He knew who I was. And every time we crossed paths, he just acted genuine. He acted, you know? I used to brag about it at school and people did not believe me whatsoever. Nobody believed me whatsoever. But you, one day, right? One time I met him at New England Picture. It was in the clip. I have a video of it.
Hey, what's up? Good. I haven't seen you in over a year, man.
I've been chasing you, Xander, to get that bat signed.
I've been trying to message you everything.
You skipped out on Foxwoods this year.
He did.
Chasing
yeah,
it is. Him.
Thank you so much. Doing good.
Of him remembering me still in 2018. That was his 4th or 5th season in the big leagues. And to just see him rise to who he's become today is unreal. It's unreal what you've become. And I'm not going to lie, you helped me get through a very tough time in my life. I was damn near close to death. And what cheered me up was flashing back memories that I've had with you, and it would put a smile on my face. Remember the one time where it was me, my mom, and her friend in Fenway Park, I'd say 3.5 hours before game time, you come out in your Barcelona shirt, right? You look dead straight at us, and we just go awkwardly because we are the only people in that stadium other than the staff and you guys. You looked up, smiled, laughed, waved back at us. You turned around after you did your runs and you went like this, came down, chatted it up a little bit. Hit a walk-off that day. Countless amount of memories. Then when we did the picnic at the park, whatever it was, right? You knew I was recording or something like that. You turned right at my camera and made the goofiest face like we were homies. No joke. That would be a picture that I would have of Mike. No joke. You know what I mean? You just felt like the homie that I didn't know on a personal level and that I only saw face to face. Anytime that I had an interaction with you, you just felt like a homie. And that was that. That was that at the end of the day. I was hoping to meet you one more time this year because I knew that it was possibly going to be the last time you were going to be here. You probably forget who I am because the last meet and greet that you had, at least, that I know of, was back in 2018. But it's okay. It's no big deal. COVID happened and all that. And I don't think you had a meet and greet ever since 2018. That's okay. It's all right. It's no big deal. But I just want you to know that you made a huge impact on my life. And I wish I got to meet you one more time because I do have a World Series jersey over here that I did want signed. But maybe when you come back to Boston, whenever that will be, I would love it if you could sign it. Maybe even personalize it. I'm not going to lie, I don't have many things that's personalized that's signed here, but that would be one that I would love to have personalized. And thanks. Thank you for the memories. I'll be here on the East Coast rooting for you. I'll be watching every single game here in Boston when you play in San Diego. I'm not even going to be watching Red Sox games anymore. I don't even know if I can watch Red Sox games anymore. Like I said, I'm done with the Red Sox. It's over and that's it. So, Xander, thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you for all you've done. Thank you for being the greatest shortstop in Red Sox history. We're going to miss you, Bogey. We're going to really miss you. I'm going to have my take on this whole entire thing on a podcast coming soon. I'll also be giving details of what is going to happen in terms of the Red Sox and this channel going forward. And to Red Sox Nation, for now at least, it's been real. It's been real. Thank you for the memories, Red Sox Nation. Thank you for cheering by my side. It's been real. Now, having said that, to Padres Nation, let's go win a World Series. Let's go win a World Series.
Hold enough to be a Marine. Oh, yeah!
Yeah! Hey, what's up?
Good.
I haven't seen you in over a year, man.
I've been chasing you, Xander, to get that bat signed.
I've been trying to message you everything.
You skipped out on Foxwoods this year.
Yeah. Yeah, he did. Yeah,
he did.
Thank you so much. Doing good.
Whatever color.
Just chilling. You got all your signing done.
Yeah, I did.
I can just kick back.
Man, my only Sox game before my procedure. Bogart's homers.